Hey guys, welcome to Pearls of Eden. Today I'm going to talk to you about the power of a vision. You know what? Kanye West, let's talk about it. No matter what you think about this man, he believes in himself, and he's not afraid to go after his dreams. And the more the Lord reveals to me about him, the more I want to see him win. Today I came across some things about him as far as his vision for 2020, wanting to run for election. It was happenstance, but maybe it wasn't, right? Because here I am talking to you about it right now. And anyways, he wrote the vision down, a powerful prophetic vision, I do believe, about him wanting to see America be a better place. Beautiful, beautiful, poetic vision that he wrote down. And there's so many things that I could say about that. But Kanye, what I will say that we all can say is he is not scared to walk after his vision, his dreams, no matter what people think. He reminds me a lot of President Trump. You know, many people said that he couldn't do it. Many people mocked, many people laughed in his face. They said he would never be president. And we all know that was proven wrong, right? And so we have to be very careful who we try to counsel and who we say is just laughable that they even want to be the president. Because as we see, when God puts his hand on you, if it's for you, no one can come against you. And so I am rooting for him. I say anybody that has a dream and a vision and they keep God first and they trust in God, hey, who's to stop you from going after you, after what you want? Let no one stop you. And this is a message to the chosen ones. No matter who laughs at your dreams, no matter how old you are, or how young you are, if you have a dream, let no one get in front of that dream to stop you from activating the vision that God has placed in your heart. Can you imagine if Donald Trump just went to the side and said, you know, this is impossible. People say I'm just a celebrity. I'm just this businessman from New York. He didn't let anyone stop him from his vision, and look where it led him, right? And so I want you to know that there'll be people that laugh at you, that people will mock you. They'll say there's no way, hell will freeze over before this happens. But you keep going after the things that God has put in your heart, and you can prove them wrong. Because if God is for you, no one can be against you. He prepares a table before thine enemies. I told you, yea is in a Psalms 23 season of his life. That is the scripture that the Lord called me to pray over him. And there were so many people that laughed that said there was no way that Ye could come back after this. There's no way he's going to be shut down. But how many of you know, how many of you understand that you cannot curse what God has blessed, right? So today's word is write the vision down. Write your vision down and activate it, implement it. Faith without works is dead. Like I tell my kids, you can write something down all day long, but if you don't have a game plan, if you don't have the faith that needs to activate the dream, then it'll be just a stalemate. There's nothing that's going to come of it. But if you do these three things, if you write the vision down, implement it, and you activate it with the currency of faith. Currency of faith, guys. Faith is the currency in the heavenly realm. Without it, you can do nothing to please God. So when you have those three components, get ready for success. Get ready for God to open up a door so big for you to walk through. But you've got to do what is necessary to activate the vision. So let's get into today's video. I hope it inspires you. It encourages you to go after your dreams, because he's not letting anyone stop him from going after his. And I admire that about him. I'm inspired by it. And you should too. Let's take a look.
I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it. Screams from the haters, got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that.
Need healing internationally, not just selfishly for America. America's number one. Internationally, we need healing. And I would lead with the love, dignity, the responsibility to our country, the coverage of our families, of our soldiers, and in full service to God and to the American people. This isn't something that you just wing. This all is going to take moments of listening, moments of understanding.
There couldn't be a better time to put a visionary in the captain's chair. I believe that my calling is to be the leader of the free world. It was something that God put on my heart back in 2015.
I went from having confidence and arrogance to having faith. And faith is the opposite of fear. And that created this fearless approach that I have. And that's what now has made me the fearless leader that I am, that I've like crystallized into the leader that my mom always knew I would be. America deserves, the world deserves a leader that they can 100% trust. Right now, we have the solutions, but we all have our backs to each other. We need to face each other. We all want the world to be better for the children. And we can show ways that we are not at odds. Think about it. The world is a giant piano, but we're playing off key. God is using me, and he has a calling in my life to make the world better for all people.
I want all the problems, because the problems are the opportunities. There's an opportunity to solve things. We will heal. We will show the world what America should be, the dream.
You gotta get a good, honest, Christian leader. And things that I work on become massively successful. So you'd want someone like me to work on our country.
Yes, yes.
Indeed.
And,
absolutely.
Do you think Trump is
simple
a true
as that.
Man of God, or do you think he's just playing an act? Do you think he knows Jesus? Do you think he's a real Christian like you?
Well, I think we all fall short of the glory, and I think one thing that Trump supporters are very energized about is the fact that we can set a standard for the way we conduct ourselves as Christians and as leaders. I think that's a big thing that Putin has an issue with in America, is that we don't follow what Christ says we should follow. I think I don't even use the word moral compass, because that puts it into a man construct as opposed to a group living by God's rules. And I think that's what's really important. Like, it's like, is it Christ-like or is it not Christ-like? And you know, it's such a blessing for me as an artist that so many great artists throughout history, a good artist, because God is a true artist, and you know, Jesus is the only power. God is the only power, but I feel so good to be a vessel and to be used by God, and to have been able to, you know, go on my walk and for God to be patient with me when I push concepts, you know, dealing with things like, you know, sexual addiction and pornography addiction. Like, there's a lot of conversation about the moral compass related to a lot of imagery that's been coming out, and things I told Kim this yesterday. I said, look, any form of perversion is bad in God's eyes. Any form of pornography, like, it tears apart families. It's used to tear families apart. You know, if it's a dad looking at what, you know, Pornhub, he's still looking at somebody's daughter. And a lot of the women that end up in pornography are actually products of molestation. And they're reliving that trauma every time they get on camera. So in Hollywood, people say, okay, this is right, but this is wrong. It's all wrong in God's eyes. And that's where we have to stand up and raise our standards as leaders, a world leader. We're the youngest country, and we're world leaders, and we are influencers. And somehow our country has been taken over by, you know, maybe about 300 Zionists.
Yes.
You know,
are the Zionists doing about the Palestinians? Nobody talks about that. They treat the Palestinians worse than they treat the black people in America. You know, and everybody shuts up about that. Nobody ever wants to talk. The same thing with, like, Valencia talking about the bondage with the kids. Are you going to convince Kim to not wear the Valencia anymore? Because, you know.
I think that not wearing certain brands is not going to solve trafficking, any form of sex trafficking. It's deeper than a logo on a brand. It just so happens that that, you know, Balenciaga is being called out, but I'm saying let's call that out. Let's call everything out.
Yes.
Let's call it all out. Let's call it all out, baby.
That's what we got to do. Call it all out and get it all out in the light just to get healed.
Exactly. Bring it to the light and get healed.
Yes, exactly. So what's next for you? A church tour?
That was the idea that you said.
Of course.
You're an inceptor.
I'm an inspirer, you know. I'm an inspirer, like, yay.
Yeah, you have good ideas. I follow God.
And God's the creator of all ideas.
Yeah. You know, I'm working on vertically integrated communities that mix water, food, education, medicine, and shelter. These are the five elements that the 1% uses to control the 99%. We have more than enough of this in the world for everyone to have it, but it's limited just to keep the older families in power, the 1,000-year-old families in power, just to keep the Vatican in power, just to keep the financial groups like BlackRock and Vanguard in power, just to keep governments in power, just to keep Hollywood media in power. You know, they came to kill me and destroy me. They tagged me as a racist. They froze my accounts. And God is, every time something happens that I lose a connection or cut ties, it just leaves more room for God to fill me up. It humbles me. And I just appreciate God for using me in this way on this Sunday, that we can testify, that we can worship, that we can say his name, Jesus, Yahshua. We can put his name on high and say that Jesus is the only way and the only life.
Yes. Yes, man. Amen. And we thank you for everything. And we hope you succeed with Ye, you know, with your company. And doesn't, you know, I don't know what else to ask.
Whatever, yeah, whatever.
So listen.
Whatever happened, that's God's plan.
Yeah.
Anything, it's all up, you know, that nothing was taken away from me. Anything that was taken away from me is because God allowed it. If I had been following God's word to a T, they wouldn't have been able to touch me. But I have been disobedient to God, so I deserve anything that was coming to me. And now I come to God and I humbly say, you know, I'm no longer doing it my way. I'm doing it your way, God.
Very well put.
Yeah. Straight from Shibuya on some Zen.
Yeah. Praise God.
Praise God. And are you going to bring back Sunday services?
Yeah. I've been talking to the pastor. The pastor works with our youth choir right now. So
beautiful.
I was talking to him.
That's beautiful, man. Beautiful jacket. Beautiful things. I can't wait till you run this country and run this world, because we need somebody like you.
Yes, sir.
And you're the current God's messenger on this earth. You get what I'm saying? People just don't get it because they're blind.
When there's a lot of messengers for God.
Of course.
I'm one of the ones. I'm in a position where I can inspire people, but it's going to take love from all the leaders. There's leaders all across this country, all across this world, and we have to show that it's fine for the leaders to step up and move with love. We got to put love first.
Yes.
You know,
exactly.
I love Biden. I love Kamala. I love Trump.
Exactly.
I love, like, DeSantis. I don't know anything about him, really, but yeah.
Would you support DeSantis over Trump?
I'd support myself. I'm always the best choice.
Of
Look
course.
At anything that we've ever been in. Go production.
Of course.
Albums, concerts, clothing. You know, I'm one of those historical Americans, like Ford or Steve Jobs or Howard Hughes or Disney. I'm yay, you know.
Yeah.
And I'm constantly looking to see if someone could do the job better than me. I just haven't found anybody yet. And I think that Trump would be a great president, but he's got to put God first in everything he does. It's God first, then America.
Yeah. Maybe that's why God took it away from him.
Then Israel.
Exactly.
All right.
What do you have to say to the Jewish people now? Are you...
You know, I love Jewish people, and I still have issues with some of the business practices, and I'm happy that I was able to stand up and say what I believed in, stand up for my truth and say it out loud, and take whatever hits they had coming from me, and the fact that people got to see it. People are seeing it and saying, wow, you know, he's right about that. No one's gonna dumb us down. I feel like the media tries to sexualize our country and tries to dumb us down and act like you know, anytime someone has a difference of opinion, they get canceled. So what does that mean? That means they're trying to keep us ignorant.
Yes.
But our country, I mean, we're the greatest inventors in history. We have so many inventors. This is the country of innovators. We created McDonald's. We created Apple. We created Amazon. This is USA. This is an intelligent country. And we will not be dumbed down by the media. And we will not be afraid of the media.
It's a conspiracy.
Fear, only fear God. And don't be condemning Balenciaga and then going to strip clubs the next day. Let's bring it all out. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yes, exactly.
As a matter of fact, I know they're going to take that as a soundbite, but take it how you want. They'll take it out of context, but hear the whole thing I'm saying. Look, if you're going to strip clubs, then you can't condemn anybody. If you're looking at pornography, you can't condemn anybody. If you're fornicating, you can't condemn anybody. The first one with no sins, throw the stones.
Yes. Take the log out of your own eye before you take the speck out of everybody else's.
Exactly. Well, yeah. You guys caught a soundbite that they could probably flip in the wrong way. But Jesus covers us.
We know. Yes, exactly. Everything's due to Jesus.
We love you, eh?
Thank you,
guys.
Thank you.
Have a good one.
All right, Mark. See you. Hey. Give me a call. See you guys.
Okay. Thank you, eh?
Yeah, Bottega. Eat glasses, Bottega. So, I wanted to just thank God for my 9 Billboard nominations. It's the most of the night, the 4 wins. Thank the Billboard Awards. Thank all my fans. Thank all of my Christians that's been praying for me, praying for the day where I would serve the kingdom. You know, God just keeps showing up. The incredible increase and the favor. And yes.